Hello and welcome to another episode of Today's GK. I am Pooja Dwivedi, and in this segment, we bring to you objective questions on a daily basis to help you crack prelims. So let's begin with the practice question of last segment. Which of the following country releases the International Religious Freedom Report? A. United States of America, B. United Kingdom, C. United Nations, or D. European Union? Many of you have answered it correctly in the comment segment. It's A, that is the USA. Moving on to the explanation, the US State Department has designated Pakistan as well as China among 8 other countries that are of particular concern for violation of religious freedom. So the United States State Department released its annual International Religious Freedom Report, which is a survey of the state of religious freedom across the world. It prepares certain lists under this. There are two lists. First is special watch list, and another one is countries of particular concern. So these two lists, if we talk about designation of the country of particular concern, is the top tier recommendation by the US Commission on International Religious Freedom when it comes to violation of international religious freedom. It is followed by special watch list countries for severe violations. This is in line with the International Religious Freedom Act of 1998, which was passed to promote religious freedom as a foreign policy of the United States. So if we talk about the countries of particular concern, in addition to Pakistan and China, Myanmar, Eritrea, Iran, Nigeria, North Korea, Saudi Arabia, Tajikistan, and Turkmenistan is there. So Nigeria is the first secular democracy. The first secular democracy, you have to keep this in mind, Nigeria is the first secular democracy which has been named a country of particular concern. And if we talk about the special watch list here, special watch list, there are certain countries by the name of Cuba, Comoros, Nicaragua, and Russia which have been listed under this particular list. Moving on, let's look at our next question. In which of the following countries Kurds community is found? A. Iran, B. Saudi Arabia, C. Sudan, or D. Morocco? The correct answer for this question is A, that is Iran. Moving on to the explanation. So the Kurds are one of the indigenous people of the Mesopotamian plains and the highlands, that is the current southeastern Turkey, northeastern Syria, northern Iraq, northwestern Iran, and southwestern Armenia. Now they form a distinctive community and they are united through race, culture, and language. Even though they have no standard dialect, right? There is no standard dialect for them. Moving on, they also adhere to a number of different religion and creeds, although they are majority Sunni Muslims. In the early 20th century, many Kurds began to consider the creation of homeland, generally referred to as Kurdistan, but the boundaries of the modern map of the Middle East made no provision for the Kurdish state and left Kurds with minority status in their respective countries. So they do not have a certain region of their own and they are just reduced to minority community in the areas they reside in, right? So that is why that particular region wherever they reside is very disturbed because of that only. They have a demand for their own homeland. Moving on to the next question. Consider the following statements. The representatives of each union territory in the Rajya Sabha are indirectly elected by members of an electoral college. The voting age was reduced from 21 to 18 years by the 61st Constitutional Amendment Act of 1988. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? A. 1 only, B. 2 only, C. both 1 and 2, D. neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this question is C, that is both 1 and 2, both the statements are correct. Moving on to the explanation, the representatives of each union territory in the Rajya Sabha are indirectly elected by members of an electoral college specially constituted for the purpose. Now, this election is held in accordance with the system of proportional representation by means of single transferable vote. There is one more system by which elections in our country are held, that is first past the post system, in which among two or more candidates, whichever candidates, whoever of the candidates has received the highest number of votes wins. So that particular system has no particular threshold. Whichever candidate receives the highest, that particular candidate wins. Moving on, the representatives of states in Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people from the territorial constituencies in the state, and every Indian citizen who is above 18 years of age and who is not disqualified under the provisions of the constitution or any other law made by the parliament is eligible to vote at such election. And this voting age was reduced from 21 to 18 years by the 61st Constitutional Amendment Act of 1988. Moving on to our next question. Which of the following countries share a border with Morocco, Tunisia, Portugal, Algeria? You have to select the correct answer using code given below. A1 and 2 only, B2 and 3 only, C3 only, or D1, 2 and 3. The correct answer for this question is C, that is 3 only. Only the third country shares a border with Morocco. So if you look at the map of Morocco here, Morocco has its capital at Rabat. And if you talk about its boundary, it shares its boundary, land boundary with Algeria, and its capital is Algiers. Now this question has been asked in the UPPSC prelims. So you have to be very careful about the capitals of different countries as well. Right, moving on to the explanation. Officially, Morocco is known as the Kingdom of Morocco, and it is a nation located in the northwestern region of Africa. It borders Algeria to the east and southeast, Western Sahara to the south, and the Atlantic Ocean to the west, and the Mediterranean Sea in the north. It is the only African country with coastal exposure to both Atlantic Ocean and the Mediterranean Sea. We have talked about the capital of Rabat. So here is the map again. I told you Algeria is a sharing boundary nation. And then you have Western Sahara here, the Sahara region, and the North Atlantic Ocean is there. And then you can see Mediterranean Sea here, very closely located to Spain as well. Moving on. With reference to initial public offering, consider the following statements. IPO is the selling of securities to the public in the secondary market. It is generally used by a new and medium-sized firm that are looking for funds to grow and expand their business. You have to tell which of the statements given above is or are correct. A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, D neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this question is answer B, that is 2 only. Moving on to the explanation. IPO is the selling of securities to the public in primary market, and it is, by the name itself you can answer it, it's initial public offering, and primary markets deal with new securities. Keep this one in mind. They deal with new securities being issued for the first time ever, and it is also known as the new issues market. So it is different from the secondary market where existing already traded securities are there and bought and sold. It is also known as the stock market or stock exchange. Also, it is when an unlisted company, that means a company which is not listed on the stock market, makes either a fresh issue of security for the first time ever, fresh issue of security, second is, or an offer for sale of already existing securities, or both, for the first time to the public. Unlisted companies, as we talked, are those companies which are not listed on the stock market, and it is generally used by a new and medium-sized firms that are looking for more funds in order to grow and expand. Right? Moving on. Samadhan doctrine, often seen in news, is related to which of the following? A. Left-wing extremism, B. Kashmir, C. Poshan Abhiyan, or D. Maternal health. The correct answer for this question is A, that is areas affected by left-wing extremism. Moving on to the explanation. It's a doctrine. It is the one-stop solution for the left-wing extremism problem. It encompasses the entire strategy of government, from short-term policy to long-term policy, formulated at different levels, and it stands for smart leadership, aggressive strategy, motivation and training, actionable intelligence, dashboard-based KPIs, that is key performance indicators and KRAs or key result areas, harnessing technology action plan for each theater and no access to financing. Now, this particular scheme should not be confused with Samadhan, which was a mega online challenge for the students in order to grow innovation amongst them. And there is also one more scheme by the name of Samadhan for helping the taxpayers of India. Also, if we talk about left-wing extremism, as of now, there are 90 districts in 11 states which are affected by left-wing extremism. We will talk about them more. Left-wing extremism organizations, these are a group that try to bring change through violent revolution. Now, they are against democratic institutions, and in order to subvert the democratic processes at ground level, they use violence, and these groups prevent the development process in the least developed regions of the country and also try to misguide the people by keeping them ignorant of current happenings. And as I told you, 90 districts affected by left-wing extremism among 11 states. Jharkhand has the highest number of districts affected by left-wing extremism, after that followed by Bihar. Some other states, if you want to know about, are West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Kerala. These are certain states which are affected by left-wing extremism, and it's very harmful for a democratic country as well as the people who reside in such regions, because they do not abide by the rules and laws of a democratic country, and in order to overthrow the government, they use violent measures. They take violent measures, right? Moving on, consider the following statements with reference to National Human Rights Commission. It is an independent statutory body established as per provisions of Protection of Human Rights Act 1993. It was established in conformity with the Paris Principles. The members and chairman of NHRC are appointed by the president on the recommendation of a high-powered committee headed by the prime minister. So, which of the statements given above is or are correct? A3 only, B2 and 3 only, C1 and 2 only, or D1, 2 and 3. Let's move back to the statements once more. Now, the correct answer for this question would be D, that is 1, 2 and 3. All the statements are correct. Moving on to the explanation, NHRC is an independent statutory body which was established on 12th October 1993 as per provisions of Protection of Human Rights Act 1993, and that was later amended in the year 2006, and it was established in conformity with the Paris Principles. Keep this in mind. And the Paris Principles, if we talk about, it was adopted for the promotion and protection of human rights in the country of Paris in the year 1991 in the month of October. So, it was endorsed by the General Assembly of the United Nations on 20th December 1993, and every year 10th December is observed as Human Rights Day. It's a multi-member body which consists of a chairman and seven other members. Out of the seven members, three are ex-officio. And the president appoints the chairman and members of NHRC on the recommendation of a high-powered committee, which is chaired by the prime minister. Keep this also in mind. The chairperson as well as the members of the NHRC, they are appointed for a time period of 3 years, with the maximum tenure of years to be 70 years. Either they can get onto the threshold of 70 years, and the maximum tenure in case of, if not completed 70 years, is 3 years, right? Moving on. Consider the following statements about Asian Elephant Specialist Group, or ASESG. It's an integral part of the Species Survival Commission of IUCN. The ASESG provides significant scientifically grounded evidence of the abundance distribution and demographic status of Asian elephant population. Only Asian. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, D neither 1 nor 2. Let's look at the statements once more. The correct answer for this question is C. Both 1 and 2, both the statements are correct. Moving on to the explanation. The IUCN Asian Elephant Specialist Group, it's a global network of specialists, both scientists and non-scientists are there, and it is concerned with the study, monitoring, management and conservation of Asian elephants, that is Elephas Maximus. The aim is to provide long-term conservation of Asia's elephant, and where possible, the recovery of the population to viable levels are also an aim for this particular group. It's an integral part of the Species Survival Commission of the International Union for Conservation of Nature, and it provides the best available scientifically grounded evidence to the abundance, distribution and demographic status of Asian elephants population in all 13 arranged states. So if we talk about International Union for Conservation of Nature, it is a very unique global partnership of governments as well as civil society organizations. It was established in the year 1948 and is headquartered at Switzerland. And if we talk about IUCN Red List, which is prepared by IUCN, is the most comprehensive inventory on the conservation status of threatened and every other species. Moving on. Gaja, it is the biannual journal of IUCNSSC Asian Elephant Specialist Group. So you have to learn that this is the biannual journal of IUCNSSC Asian Elephant Specialist Group by the name of Gaja. Let's look at our next question. KLI project is recently in use, is associated with submarine optical fiber cable connectivity, tourism industry in Lakshadweep Islands, security and radar sensation between India and China, or seabed mining of polymetallic nodules in Indian Ocean. The correct answer for this question is A, that is submarine optical fiber cable connectivity, and yes, it is related to Lakshadweep. So the Union Cabinet has given its approval for provision of submarine optical fiber cable connectivity between mainland Kochi and Lakshadweep Islands, the KLI project. The project, it envisages provision of a direct communication link through a dedicated submarine optical fiber cable between Kochi and 11 islands of Lakshadweep. So in the year 2020, in the month of August, optical cable connectivity was also done between Chennai and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Also, if we talk more about it, the project would be funded by Universal Service Obligation Fund, and the project will vastly improve telecommunication facilities in Lakshadweep Islands by providing large bandwidth. Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited has been nominated as Project Execution Agency and Telecommunication Consultant India Limited. So you have to also be very mindful of the fact that BSNL has been nominated as the project executor here. Moving on, consider the following statements. India is a member of the World Trade Organization, enacted the Geographical Indication of Goods, Registration and Protection Act of 1999. The Pedanna Kalam Kari was the first Indian product to get the Geographical Indication tag. Now look at the statements. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? I hope you have seen the options 1 only, 2 only, both 1 and 2 and D, neither 1 nor 2. Statements once more. Now we see the options. The correct answer for this question is A, that is 1 only. Only the first statement is correct. Moving on to the explanation. A geographical indication is a sign used on products that have a specific geographical origin and possesses qualities or a reputation that are due to that origin. Now, India, as a member of the WTO, it enacted the Geographical Indications of Goods Registration and Protection Act of 1999, and this act came into force with effect from 15 September 2003. So if we talk about geographical indication of goods, these goods can be manufactured goods, or these can be organically occurring goods, processed or as well as produced. Moving on, to our next statement about it. In 2004, Darjeeling tea was the first Indian product to get the geographical indication tag. Pridanna Karam Kari also has the geographical indications tag, and it was included in the geographical indications registry in the year 2012. Right? Moving on. Consider the following statements with reference to Global Tiger Initiative. It is a global alliance of governments, international organizations, civil society, and the conservation and scientific communities and the private sector with the aim of working together to save wild tigers from extinction. In 2013, the scope was broadened to include snow leopards and Asiatic lions as well. World Bank is one of the founding partners of GTI, beg your pardon. Which of the statements given above are correct? A1 and 2 only, B2 and 3 only, C1 and 3 only, or D1, 2 and 3? The correct answer for this question is D, that is 1, 2 and 3. All the statements are correct. Moving on to the explanation, GTI, it was launched in the year 2008, and it's a global alliance of governments, international organizations, civil society, and the conservation and scientific communities and the private sector has an aim of working together to save the wild tigers from extinction. In the year 2013, the scope was broadened to include snow leopards as well. And you have to keep this in mind. In which year? 2013. The scope was broadened to include snow leopards as well. Also, the GTI's founding partners, if we talk about, are World Bank, the Global Environment Facility, the Smithsonian Institution, Save the Tiger Fund, and International Tiger Coalition, which represents more than 40 non-government organizations. Now, this initiative is led by 13 Tiger Range countries. How many countries? 13 Tiger Range countries. So, if we talk about tiger population in India, India comprises of the 75% of global tiger population. And as of now, if we talk about the current census of tigers, India has 2,967 tigers. This is an estimated value. Alright, the highest number of tigers are present in the state of Madhya Pradesh, followed by Karnataka, and then Uttarakhand. Alright, moving on to the practice question for our next segment. Bhasan Char, an island recently in the news, is located in A. Arabian Sea, B. Bay of Bengal, C. Andaman Sea, or D. Gulf of Aden. Now, we have talked about Bhasan Char a lot of times recently. Char is a Bengali word for sediment. I hope this gives you a hint. Bengali word for sediment. I hope it gives you a hint. So, I hope you will be able to answer it correctly in the comment segment. That's it for today. Tomorrow we shall meet again. Thank you so much for watching.